All right, we want to discuss some basic principles about searching off of a handline in a large commercial structure or a large residential structure with multifamily type dwelling applications. If we have commonalities or identifiable landmarks, benchmarks within that structure, whether it's cubicle runs, aisleway runs, or common hallways with multiple doors that are staggered, all of those benchmarks in basic theology kind of eliminate some of that need for orientation components, because you can stay oriented to the structure itself based on those components. If you don't have that, predominantly in a large open bay type environment, then you are ideally hoping that that line is in place, or you're going to deploy that search line. Before we ever make entry into that structure as that RIT team, we want to process as much information from the potential Mayday report as possible. So we want to not just read the fire, read the structure, and do those assessments that we talked about, exterior and interior. We want to add a layer to that that filters all of that information through the last known location of our firefighters. Was it a hose team on a hand line or on a large supply line coming into the structure, or perhaps a garden lay, anything along those lines? Where were those guys last known location? What else did their Mayday report include? Did they talk about actions that they were going to take, directions they were going to potentially travel in, and any other actions they were going to take as far as activating pass devices, audible tool sounds? You want to try and take all that information and very quickly apply it to your action plan. So if that line is in place and we don't have a definitive last known location on that line or what they intended to do, then we're going to try and make our way all the way to the nozzle to initiate things. There's two things that provide for us as a RIT team. Number one, it gets us to a secondary point of protection. So as that RIT team, we're always looking for alternative means of egress. When we're just on a search line, we don't have an additional interior component that can give us a protective measure inside and potentially protect our fellow firefighters that are in that down firefighter position. Getting to that nozzle gives us an additional control point so that we can help mitigate, manage, or control that fire environment from inside the structure. Once we're at that nozzle, we are also starting from the deepest potential last known point of that team, which is probably the most ideal portion of that environment, and starting our search from there and working our way back. The other added benefit of that is, if that initial team makes their way as far into the structure as possible to that nozzle, starts to search there, clears that area, then all the subsequent searches from there, or secondary and third searches, are getting shorter and shorter, closer and closer to that primary entry point, which means each one of those searches can be more effective and more efficient. So it's kind of like getting your most difficult work or most challenging work done first. And then once we complete that zone, it's important to make a decision as to whether you're going to leave that line in as a landmark or bench point for where that last known location was, or you're going to utilize that nozzle to kind of pull back out of the structure as you're retreating in your search to help identify those last known points of your completed search zone. So there's several different variables to consider when working off of that handline. Additionally, the actual application of deploying off of that, we want to try and utilize the same principles that we've utilized off of the search line. So we're going to use our thermal imaging cameras prolifically. If we have a problem with those, then we can start relying on some retractable components and either doing Z-pattern searches or radial searches off of those main elements. We're going to try and demonstrate a couple of those variables for you so you can see those things in action. As far as the thermal imaging applications go, they're basically going to be the same as the search line, and make sure that you're using voice orientation and that you're maintaining control of your group.